Let's get a move on though and focus in on earnings on Manappuram Finance in particular. The company has seen their collection efficiency improving as well as a sharp rise in their gross NPAs. Mr. VP Nandakumar is the Managing Director and CEO and now joins in for more perspective. Good morning, Mr. Nandakumar. Let's begin by talking about your profit growth because that has been quite stellar in Q4. What has led to the AUM gold decline and the gold loan auctions worth 400 crore rupees?
So one reason is the gold price fluctuation. When the gold price gone up during last year, those who availed a higher loan amount per gram, now they will not be able to get that because the gold price has gone down by 28%. So when these are becoming overdue, they were not able to reset the loan or redeem the loan. It's a new LTV. So around 2% of outstanding or on the loan dispersal, half a percent of these people, these went for auction. This is one reason. Another thing, when the gold price is down by 21%, there will be a reduction in the portfolio also because upon the same quantity of gold, what they can avail is lower now. This is the reason for the reduction in the portfolio. So this happens when there is a wide fluctuation like this.
Understood. And walk us through what the impact has been of the second wave on delinquencies in gold loans. What is the reason behind customers defaulting on their gold loans? And more importantly, do you think that this sort of a trajectory is likely to continue? How is it impacting your financials?
So one thing in gold loan, there will not be any credit loss. Our product is 3 months, and within another 3 months, we get this either renewed at the new LTV, or we ask people to redeem it. And only whatever is the balance, 1 or 2%, is going for auction. So the second way, what we see is the activities are not completely paralyzed. Some activities are happening in some states. The last year lockdown, what has happened, that there India was in a lockdown. So, and also with the penetration of vaccination and other facilities and other better compliance of COVID protocol by the officers, I think the impact of the second COVID will be much less than the first one.
I also wanted to understand exactly how do you then plan to mitigate this volatility in gold prices? Because as much as 2020 turned out to be a phenomenal year of return for gold, that's not quite been the case year to date.
So perhaps we may be the one player in gold loan where the risk is mitigated very much. Price risk is mitigated very much. So our loan product is of 3 months only, whereas in the market the other lenders are offering it for 1 year. So had we been offering for 1 year, our risk would have been higher. So our LTV used to be around 70%. So even if there is a decline of some 10-15%, we may not totally lose. We may not lose our principal, any portion of the principal, or not even interest. We will be able to protect the entire receivables. So the fluctuation this year was very high, to the tune of 21%. Normally this won't happen, but now in our books we have already cleared these highest LTV offerings we had through the redemption by the customers or even renewal at the new LTV, etc. So we are able to mitigate. So the mitigation is the shortening the tenure of the product and asking the customers to service the loan at frequent periodicities. We have offered online platform for this purpose, and around 70% of the loans are transacted through online now.
Sure. What one has seen, Mr. Nandakumar, is that there has been a rise in NPAs. Wanted to understand what kind of provisioning levels as well as gross net NPAs do you foresee for the full year?
So, gold loan is our major portfolio. Over 70% is gold loan. There, the NPA is only technical. The reason is, when these were come up for auction, it was in a lockdown condition where the bidders and the public auctioneers were not able to reach out. So that's the reason. So the gold loan, all the NPAs will get liquidated during the proceeding month. It will not end up in any credit loss. So in other businesses like microfinance, we have made sufficient provision, very conservative provision. And the results are based out of that only. In commercial vehicle, home loans, MSME, etc., which are other lines of business also, the collections have come to the come to a very high level towards the end of the last fiscal. It was ranging from 105 to 115% in these three segments. So we have adequately provided, and this year we hope things will be far better. So whatever needs to be provided, we are providing. We don't expect a huge provision needed.
Growth trends in the non-gold AUM book, and can you walk us through the view on the share of non-gold AUMs?
The non-gold AUM is around 30% now. Our overall objective in the long term is to bring that down to the gold down to 50%. That doesn't mean that we are not giving importance to gold loan. Gold loan is very important for us. But so we have a brand network of over 4,000 in the country. We'll be able to sell these three products across the country because for brand equity and a large customer base of over 50 lakhs. So with that, we hope the other segments like MSME, which is insecure, then affordable housing finance, and commercial vehicle finance and microfinance, etc. These businesses will grow at a higher percentage and reach a level of around 20% of the consolidated portfolio in another 5-6 years.
Okay, and what is the outlook on your capital raising plans? Are you currently, do you have sufficient capital on your books?
Yeah. In the parent book, the capital adequacy is around 28%. Even in microfinance, our capital adequacy is around 24%. In other businesses like affordable housing, etc., it is still much higher. So we don't require any capital for the purpose of growth. It is we are not leverage as per our plan. It is still less leverage only. So there is enough scope to build the business using the existing capital itself.
All right, Mr. Nandakumar, we'll let you go on that note. Appreciate you taking the time out and joining in with a perspective on your earnings as well as the outlook on your margins, the impact of the second wave. Let's slip into a very quick break, but stay with us. When we come back, we'll have the management.